Hello everyone and welcome to College Research. My name is Dr. Barbara Zorn-Arnold and I'm a full-time faculty member at Ashford University. In this video, we will discuss three important topics. We'll review the difference between scholarly and popular sources, we'll develop successful search terms, and then we'll find excellent articles using the Ashford University Library. Scholarly sources are found in academic journals. Sometimes these are called peer review articles. These articles are written by experts who have advanced degrees and are often associated with universities. Then the articles are reviewed by other experts. In contrast, popular sources are magazines and websites that do not undergo a review process. You'll find that there's a broad range of resources available to you. At the far left-hand side, we have sensational sources, such as the National Enquirer. Then there are popular sources, including magazines such as Popular Science and Good Housekeeping. They also include online websites, such as Wikipedia, encyclopedias, and dictionaries. These sources should never be used for our classroom assignments because they are not reputable. Reputable sources include major newspapers, government and university websites. And some examples of scholarly sources include the Journal of Environmental Management, Ecology, and the Journal of Environmental Health and Toxicology. For discussion responses in Science 207, you should be able to use reputable and scholarly sources. For the Week 3 outline and for the final paper, you must only use scholarly sources in order to earn a good grade. And finally, sensational and popular sources should not be used for any homework assignments. Before we head to the library, we'll have to develop some successful search terms. The most effective search terms are based on your hypothesis, and these can be organized by cause and effect, comparison, or a controversial issue. For example, a cause and effect uses terms such as cause, impacts, or effects. For example, humans cause species extinction. Comparisons use terms such as same or different. For example, habitat preservation is the same as species preservation. And a controversial terms might include undervalued, misinterpreted, or misunderstood. For example, humans have a misunderstood impact on species extinction. Any of these would make excellent search terms. The library can be accessed through our classroom. Just click on the Library tab, and then click on Find Articles and More, then Databases A through Z, and click on E for EBSCO Host or EBSCO Host. This is an excellent database because it provides you with a broad range of articles from different fields, including business, education, psychology, and science. The EBSCOhost search field is very similar to any other online database. In the upper left-hand side, I've typed in human causes, selected the word and from the dropbox, and then typed in species extinction. That dropbox allows you to check three different Boolean phrases, and, or, and not. This will allow you to focus your search. Then on the right-hand side, you have additional choices. You may select a field, which includes words in the title or words from the abstract. I've left it open in order to have a broader results. I've also checked full text in order to get access to the entire article to use for my research. This search term resulted in 22 articles, most of which are academic journals. Notice that the icon next to the journal article says academic journal. This lets you know that this is a scholarly article. Let's take a closer look at one of these articles. You'll notice that this journal is titled Global Ecology and Biogeography. The author is associated with the University of Tennessee, and the article also has a reference section. This allows readers to verify the information that's found in the article. Another benefit to using Ashford's library is that you can automatically format your sources according to APA guidelines. Simply click on the article title, then click on Cite, and then you'll have a list of different format options. Just simply select APA, and then you may copy and paste it directly into your research paper. Some of you may be thinking, those are an awful lot of steps to go through for a few articles. Isn't Google easier? Well, not really. I used the same exact search terms in Google, and it resulted in 22 million different websites. And let's be honest, how many websites will a person go through before settling on the first few pages? Notice that most of these are popular sources, which are not suitable for our classroom assignment. Let's review tips for efficient research. Base your search terms on your hypothesis. Includes words such as cause, effect, same, different, or misunderstood. This will ensure that you will find articles that directly reflect your ideas and help you develop an excellent paper. Use EBSCOhost to search for articles. Focus your search by using phrases such as and, or, and not from the Dropbox options. And verify that the paper is scholarly by reviewing the author's credentials and reference page. There are also articles that may be unclear as to whether they are scholarly or not. If you are ever uncertain, be sure to ask your instructor. If you're interested in learning more about writing research papers, these are all excellent sources to consult. Well, thanks for watching the video, and happy